Each of us encounters conflict every day with our families, friends, at work, in society. But our conflicts rarely turn violent. Instead, we discuss the problem, compromise, take turns, negotiate, or just plain walk away. As individuals, we prefer to avoid violence. However, groups of people sometimes respond in one of the most violent ways possible, through war. War is costly, wasteful, and inhumane. It stands in the way of cooperating to solve the threats to human survival. As pandemics threaten, the ice caps melt, and nature weeps, humanity must adopt new approaches to safety and security. Fighting amongst ourselves will not save us. Many people think there has always been war and there always will be war. But scientific evidence shows that some societies, past and present, have successfully shunned war by creating peace systems. Peace systems are clusters of neighboring societies that do not make war on each other. There are various historic and cross-cultural examples of peace systems, from tribal peoples to nations, and even to regions. The study of peace systems provides novel insights for ending wars and could help usher in an era of unsurpassed global cooperation. Peace systems share several characteristics. One key feature is the development of an overarching social identity, an inclusive identity that expands the us to include the them. Most citizens of the European Union, which was created to prevent wars, now hold an overarching identity as Europeans in addition to local and national identities. The historically warring Swiss cantons, some Protestant, some Catholic, some small, some large, came to perceive themselves as non-warring members of one larger and diverse social entity, the country of Switzerland. War among cantons is nowadays considered a thing of the past, long ago replaced by a multi-ethnic, multilingual society where a diverse citizenry live peaceably together.
I may be a native speaker of French, but my parents originally came from German-speaking Switzerland, and I myself worked in an Italian-speaking area. I live in a neighborhood in which over 100 different nationalities live together in peace and harmony.
Peace systems also employ non-warring norms, values, symbols, and narratives to reinforce unity, cooperation, and peace. The indigenous peoples of the Upper Xingu peace system in Brazil believe that war is immoral. The Orang Asli societies of peninsular Malaysia constitute a peace system and socialize their children to act non-violently. The Haudenosaunee of North America replaced a cultural orientation towards war and revenge with non-warring norms and values, emphasizing unity and peace through law.
Hereabouts are five nations, each with its own council fire, yet they shall live together as one household in peace. Our strength shall be in union, and our way, the way of reason, righteousness, and peace.
Generally, peace systems value and promote intergroup trade, marriages among the constituent groups, and common ceremonies, which can help their members see the common humanity across social lines thus cementing relationships and building trust. The five Nordic nations have not warred with each other in over 200 years. They engage in regular commerce, transborder cooperation, and proudly refer to their own Nordic peace brand of conflict resolution. As a person from one of the societies within the Upper Xingu peace system expresses,
"We don't make war. We have festivals to which all of the villages come. We sing, dance, trade, and wrestle."
Our destinies are intertwined. Global challenges such as climate change, loss of biodiversity, and nuclear proliferation require humanity to work together on solutions. The existence of peace systems demonstrates that humans can create alternatives to war and can cooperate to bring about a positive future. We must recognize the reality of global interdependence and the necessity of cooperating to tackle existential threats, while keeping our national identities, we can also adopt a more inclusive human identity. The Cayuga, Mohawk, Oneida, Onondaga, and Seneca peoples of North America lived in fear of each other and of societies further afield. Then, these five tribes transformed into a union of cooperating neighbors, calling themselves the Haudenosaunee. For 300 years, until disrupted by the arrival of Europeans, they unified and stopped making war with each other. According to legend, the Haudenosaunee planted a great white pine and buried their weapons of war beneath it, symbolizing their new norms, values, and intertribal relations based on peace. Their success offers a parable for humanity about abolishing war and promoting instead human unity, cooperation, and well-being.